whereof make glad the city of God. Welcome to the live streams of the Green River Pentecostal Church. Our prayer is that you will be blessed and encouraged, as we join together in worship, and strengthened as we exhort one another through God's holy word. May God's blessing be upon you as we step into the life-giving stream of the Lord.
Well, somebody shout praise the Lord. Are you glad to be back in church tonight? This great revival. A lot of the tension's over here in this side room right now because back there on a cot is Sister Pam Hubble. Won't y'all let her know that you're glad to have her? I told her we'd pack her out here somewhere, but she didn't want to be on the camera. She's having to lay down, but she's thrilled to be here tonight, and we're excited that she is here. Somebody shout praise the Lord. I tell you what we're going to do. How about this? Everybody that will, how about we just come forward tonight to start? Don't that sound good? We'll just start right up here in the front tonight. Those of you that want to come, those of you that don't, that's fine. Won't you turn around, greet somebody, and tell them it's good to see you at church tonight. Thank you. Jerusalem was a shaken. Pentecost had arrived. An upper room experience. They were drunk on new wine. Well, Peter stood among them, said there is no doubt. This Holy Ghost in power will surely make you shout. That fire. It's that fire. Shut up in my bones. This Holy Ghost in fire. Shut up in my bones. Jerusalem was a shaking. Pentecost had arrived, an upper room experience. They were drunk on new wine. But Peter stood among them and said, there is no doubt. This Holy Ghost power will surely make you shout. This fire, shut up in my bones. This Holy Ghost fire, shut up in my bones.
Pentecost had arrived in the upper room chamber. They were drunk on honey wine. Well, Peter stood among them. He said, there is no doubt. This Holy Ghost and fire, it'll make them dance and shout. It's just like fire. It's just like
much moving about. Don't tell me to be quiet or go sit into my pew. If you felt this one I felt, you'd be shouting too. It's that fire in my bones. It's that fire. Shut up in my bones. Drinking the old wine, you need something new. Let me tell you about a high found I got a fix for you. Go ahead. You don't take it like a pill, it comes straight out of heaven. Brother, you know it's real. Have you ever been so drunk that you didn't know your name? So intoxicated on something you can't explain. Have you rolled across the floor? Had to have a pack you home. Let me tell you about a new wine that I've been drinking on.
First verse. Brother, you know it's real. Have you ever been so drunk didn't know your name. So intoxicated on something you can't explain. Had to roll across the floor, had to have them pack you home. Let me tell you about a new wine that I've been drinking on. Well, you can't put new wine in no bottle. It's got to be a change. That life that you've been living, it needs to be rearranged. If you think the old is better, then we won't agree. But if you're looking for something different, come go drinking with me. Have you ever been so drunk that you didn't know your name? So intoxicated on something you can't explain. Have you rolled across the floor? Had to have them pack you home. Let me tell you about a new wine that I've been drinking on. Get baptized, go drinking at the fountain, never does run dry. We'll stop off at the well where the living waters flow. I'll let you meet my Father, introduce you to the Holy Ghost. Have you ever been so drunk that you didn't know your name? So intoxicated on something you can't explain. Have you rolled across the floor? Had to have them pack you home. Let me tell you about a new wine that I've been drinking on.
The weapon may be for, but it won't prosper. When the darkness falls, it won't prevail. 'Cause the God I serve knows only how to triumph. Oh, my God will never fail. I said the weapon may be for, but it won't prosper. When the darkness falls, it won't prevail. 'Cause the God we serve knows only how to triumph. Oh, my God will never fail. Oh, my God will never fail. I'm gonna see a victory. I'm gonna see a victory. For this battle belongs to you, Lord. Oh, I'm gonna see a victory. I'm gonna see a victory. For the battle belongs to you, Lord. There's power in the mighty name of Jesus. And every war he wages, he will win. No, I'm not backing down from any giant, 'cause I know how this story ends. Yes, I know how this story ends. Oh, I'm gonna see a victory. I'm gonna see a victory. For the battle belongs to you, Lord. Oh, I'm gonna see a victory. I'm gonna see a victory. For this battle belongs to you, Lord. There's power in the mighty name of Jesus. And every war he wages, he will win. Oh, I'm not backing down from any giant, 'cause I know how this story ends. Oh, yes, I know how my story ends. I'm gonna see a victory. Oh, I'm gonna see a victory. For the battle belongs to you, Lord. I'm gonna see a victory. Oh, I'm gonna see a victory. For this battle belongs to you, Lord. 'Cause you take what the enemy for evil, and you turn it for good. You turn it for good. You take what the enemy meant for evil, and you turn it for good. You turn it for good. You take what the enemy meant for evil, and you turn it for good. You turn it for good. You take what the enemy meant for evil, and you turn it for good. You turn it for good. I'm gonna see a victory. Oh, I'm gonna see a victory. For the battle belongs to you, Lord. You're gonna see a victory. For your battle belongs to the Lord. I'm gonna see a victory. Oh, I'm gonna see a victory. For the battle belongs to you, Lord. Oh, I'm gonna see a victory. I'm gonna see a victory. For this battle belongs to you, Lord.
Can't you feel me hold you? Come on, we can do better than that. We can do better than that. We're not alone tonight. There's a lot of times we may be in a car by ourselves, we may be at home by ourselves, or we think we are. But remember what the promise of the Lord was: I'll never leave you, I'll never forsake you, but I'll be with you even unto the end of the world. This morning, one of our young ladies, Olivia Strong, was sitting at a red light. And I don't know all the details of the story, but she was sitting there and the light changed and was green. And a lady that was doing what she said about 55 mile an hour just didn't apply her brakes. Olivia didn't go because, number one, it's not wise to just floor it whenever the light turns green, especially if you're in Somerset. This didn't happen in Somerset, I don't guess. But however, this lady rear-ended her, and tonight she is suffering with broken ribs. My wife's attorney, my wife showed him the picture of the car, and I've not looked at it, but he told her, that girl's lucky to be alive. No, she's not lucky to be alive. She's blessed to be alive. And the reason why she's alive is because she wasn't alone. Look at your neighbor and say, she wasn't alone. And this morning or this evening, let me tell you, you don't have to be alone either. If you don't know Him as Lord and Savior, that promise that I'll never leave you, I'll never forsake you, but I'll be with you even unto the end of the world, it applies to those that call Him Lord, to those that call Him Savior, to those that call Him their Master. And tonight, we're just going to bring Brother Glenn on. Now listen, there's going to be plenty of time for worship still. There'll be an altar call here just a little bit. But we've been just having church for about an hour and a half, hour and 45 minutes, and he's been late getting up here. And I told him last night we were going to sing a couple of songs and bring him up. But you know what? You can still have church. Some of them didn't leave. What time did you all leave last night over here in this back room? What time?
I don't know. I left 10:30 and they're still in here.
12 o'clock? They were having church. God was doing things. God's still able to do things. I told them we all just go back there and have church, but y'all wouldn't fit. Would you give Brother Glenn Wilson a good hand clap of appreciation? We're glad that you came tonight. God bless you, brother. You too, buddy.
Thank you so much. My, we greet you in the name of Jesus tonight. And my, you all like bad breath. You just keep coming back, don't you? Amen. But that's a good thing. That's a good thing. Great to see you tonight. And I'm enjoying this revival, what God's doing around here. People's getting saved, filled with the Holy Ghost, and a host of other things that I don't even know about. Hallelujah. We have a wonderful guest with us tonight, Thomas Hoag. He and I go way back. Yeah. And Sister Kay, his wife, and I don't get to see him much now that he's pastoring, but I remember he and I started about the same time. We've got some treasured memories, and I believe I stayed. Tommy, if I'm correct, you lived down here in a trailer years ago, and me and my family come over and stayed, and I was trying to point out to my wife which trailer that was, if it was still there. But you want to say something before I preach, my man? Sister Kay, what about you? All right, we're glad you're here. Thank God. Brother Ricky's been with us every night. He's working a full-time job, getting home just long enough to brush his teeth and get a fast shower, I guess. Yeah, and I so appreciate him. Appreciate you. And all things. Turn your Bibles, if you would, to the book of Kings, chapter 10, verse 4. I have a saddened heart tonight, in a way. We got news coming over here from my oldest brother that a good friend of mine was putting up his tractor in the barn, and he got out to open up the gate. And I don't know the details, but evidently he failed to put it totally in gear, or out of gear, rather. And he got out to open the gate, and the tractor run over him and killed him. And, man, you just don't never know, do you? I told my oldest brother, I said, that ought to show you, man, you never know. And this guy was, I don't know that he was going to church anywhere, but he was known to be a moneymaker. Around our area, bought up a lot of land, had a lot of cattle, rental properties, and you name it. Seemed like his world was, just to make money. How many of those people can get caught up in this old world, man, making money and doing things, and it's good. There's nothing wrong with making money, but there's limits on everything. Never leave God out. I'm glad that I didn't leave him out. How about you? I'm glad one night, praise God, that I prayed at an old altar and God came into my life. And, you know, I let loose of a lot of things, but he's filled me up with so many other good things. How about you? You know, there's nothing he's taken from us that he won't replace with something greater and a decent, pure. And we Christians have, I believe we have more fun by mistakes than the world has on purpose. They spend so much money trying to have fun, and you and I just, you know, we just get high in the Holy Ghost or stay empowered with God, and we have our difficulties, but thank God we've got God to get us through them. Amen. Are you there? Chapter 10, the first book of Kings, and verse 4. First Kings, chapter 10, verse 4. And when the queen of Sheba had seen all Solomon's wisdom and the house that he had built, and the meat of his table, and the sitting of his servants, and the attendance of his ministers, and their apparel, and his cupbearers, and his ascent by which he went up unto the house of the Lord, there was no more spirit in her. And she said to the king, it was a true report that I heard in mine own land of the acts and of thy wisdom. Howbeit I believed not the word until I came, and mine eyes had seen it, and behold, the half was not told me. Thy wisdom and prosperity exceed the fame which I heard. Thank you, Father. Please add your blessings to the word, and I know that you will in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. The Queen of Sheba did not believe the greatness that Solomon succeeded in. Had to come and see for herself. And when she got there, I said there was no more spirit in her. It was so marvelous. I think it's going to be that way when we move into heaven. Amen. I want to use for a topic tonight simply, behold, the half was never told or has never been told. And I'm believing that if for the preachers that sit here tonight, the teachers and the learned people, there's not a one of us, I don't think, could explain how great heaven's going to really be. We can exhort on it, we can talk about it, but I'm going to tell you, when we move into our home, friend, it's going to be such an exciting time for you and I. Hallelujah. We could look around and say, man, I've heard, while I was on earth, I heard a lot of great preachers and a lot of great teaching on heaven. Oh, and I thought I had a great vision of heaven. But oh, nothing compares with what I see, praise God. I guess the best example that I could give you tonight in my feeble approach to this message, I was brought up very poor. They were five of us children, lived out in the country. I remember that old house. We had old grate fires that you had to bring in kindling and coal, you know, for a fire. You'd warm one side and turn around and warm the other side. In our bedroom, we didn't have no wallpaper except cardboard boxes. With tacks, my dad, we'd go down to the store and get thumbtacks and tack it around the wall to keep the old wind out. Our windows were plastic that we bought and put around them because all the glass was broken out of them. We were very poor, very poor. And one day my uncle, he was a traveler and he'd come by. He'd been to Florida and he talked about how wonderful it was there. I mean, knows a lot of people can put up a great picture. Words can take you into fascination. A story can take you into dreamland, dream world, you might say. And we would sit around, had no TV, had hardly anything, just a family that loved one another. We'd sit around while he sat there, and he would tell all about Florida. Man, my little old mind just absorbed all of that. And he talked my dad into going to Florida, moving down there. And my dad went. He investigated things. He got him a good job. Not only that, but a house in Florida with the job. They gave him a house with the job as long as he was there. And he come back and he began, mother wasn't convinced. He had to come back and convince mother. He said, honey, it's got windows. It's got real windows. It's got an indoor toilet. It's got this. It's got that. Finally, mother consented to it. We loaded up an old truck with what furniture we had. We tore out for Florida. I remember when we got there, my. Brother Billy, that place was marvelous. I mean, my uncle, my dad tried to explain how it was. Now, I'm telling you, we were poor. I mean, so poor we were. And we weren't used to anything like that. When we moved in there, those big rooms, I don't think we'd ever seen a telephone before. That thing had a telephone in it. Hey, man, we just went and flushed the commode just to hear it flush. Hallelujah. It was like, you know, it was like, Dad, you never told us all of it. Behold, the half was not told.
And I can't help but think, friend, when you and I are going to get to heaven, we were going to say something like that. Oh, Brother Wilson tried to explain it. Brother Naylor tried to explain it. I heard a lot of other preachers try to tell about all the fruits there, the trees there, the horses there, the furniture there, God Almighty there, Jesus Christ there. They told all the foundations. Some of those preachers could even name all 12 foundations. But oh my God, the half was never told us. This place is beyond recognition or explaining to. And I'm going to tell you tonight, sinner, if you're sitting here, you're missing out on a good going away. Glory to God. Because you're not going with us. I'm sad to say that. You've got another destiny. The Bible says there's only a heaven out there that awaits those the redeemed, and there's a hell that awaits those that are lost for Him. Oh, I'm going to tell you, you ought to get in while you can get in. We know things are closing up on us. We know that it's the end time. You look around, look at the news, read the Word of God. We're right at the brink of Jesus coming for the church. You might not believe that, but you're going to wake up one day and you're going to find we've gone to our new home. Bless God. Behold, the half has never been told. Oh, I remember a good friend of mine that died. He was older than me. And oh, he was such a joy to be around. How many has been around people that just inspired you? You wanted to hang out with them. And I remember the story was told like this. He was out in his backyard raking the yard or something. Had a stroke. And the wife rushed him to the hospital. One thing led to another. And he was dying. And his wife told it this way. She said, Brother Wilson, I was sitting there in the chair. And he just took his little hand and motioned for me. I went over to the bedside and took his hand. And he said, Hazel, that was her name, said, Hazel, honey, I love you and the boys more than anything on this old earth. He said, but I've just had a vision of the other side and said, the grass is so much greener over there. Please don't pray for me to stay. I'm tired. I'm old. I want to go home. And friend, just a few moments, he drifted off with the Lord. My God, that's a story that needs to be told. That's going to happen. You and I are going to move out of this old body. We're going to move out of this old earth. I don't care what kind of a mansion you live in or how great your riches are. Friend, you've never seen nothing like the family of God's going to inherit or already have inherited. Hallelujah. I'd like to whet your appetite so bad you'd want to go home tonight. Amen. If we knew how wonderful it was, we'd probably pray, God, let me die and go on. Hallelujah. Because the half has never been told. But there's another thing that we've got to talk about. You know, there's negatives and positives in this gospel, isn't there? Now, if you don't go to heaven, friend, you're going to go to hell. And I don't say that proudly. I say that with humility. All sinners that don't know God's going to go to hell. And I wonder, has the half ever been told about hell? I'm nothing in myself. I give up God all the glory. But I've preached some good messages in my time. I've been gifted to preach messages on hell. I've had people that tell me from time to time, ain't nobody can preach on hell like Glenn Wilson. Now, I tell you what they said, not what I'm saying. But I guarantee you, I've never preached the half of what's going on down there. I guarantee you, no man or no woman could tell you how horrible what is going on down there tonight. Oh my God, we just get bits and pieces of it. But I do know this, friend. When you get there, you ain't gonna like it. I'd say if God would roll back hell and let someone come out of hell, say He let Judas come up, or somebody you, some of your loved ones that have went on, or some of my loved ones that have went over, my God, they'd push this preacher out of the way and said, preacher, you're trying your best, but behold, you don't know the half. I've been there. I've got the smoke of hell on me. My God, I've been in torment for years and years. There's no limit to time down here. My God. God, they're crying day and night, running through hell. The drunkards here. My God, the baby beaters here. The aborters here. The homosexuals down there. Oh, tell everybody that you can. Don't come to this awful place. You preachers don't know what you're talking about. The half has never been told. Hallelujah. And I believe that. The Bible says there'll be wailing and gnashing of teeth. Man, you have to be in awesome pain or fear to manifest that kind of demonstration of pain. And think about what's down there tonight. Think about waking up in hell and realizing, my God, I'll never feel what an air-conditioned room feels like. I'll never know what it means to come out of the hot sun and step into a cool house. I'll never know what it means to drink a cool drink from the mountain stream. I'll never again get to see my loved ones and hear my babies cry or hear my wife tell me, I love you, honey. I'll never get to enjoy my grandbabies. My God, hell's that bad. And the half's never been told. It's not been told, the misery that's going on down there. My God, I'm glad I'm saved. Look at your neighbor and say, I'm glad I'm saved tonight. My. I mean, man, I could shout. The night that I come out of that gambling hall and went to that little Pentecostal church in my hometown. I'd been to a Pentecostal church twice in my life, I believe. My first visit, I sat there and made fun of them. I thought these people ain't nothing but crazy, friend. That preacher's out of his mind. But oh, that night God got a hold of my life, got a hold of my soul, pulled me to that altar. I prayed and gave my life to Jesus. I'm going to tell you, friend, my name's in that book up there along with millions of others. And one of these days, I'm going to cash it in. I'd like to run to him. And I say, I don't care about all the beauty. I want to find Jesus. I want to get to his feet. I want to honor him and praise him and thank him for that night that he reached down in sin and saved me. Pull me out of the miry clay of sin. Put my feet on solid ground and establish my going. Glory to God. But oh, my friend, if you don't know Jesus, if you don't know Jesus, you think you've been through some pain. You think you've hurt. You think you've seen the worst. The half has never been told what a horrible place that's going to be. And may I further inform you, if that wasn't enough, one day hell's going to have to assemble before the great white throne of judgment, and the God that you refused all these years going to look you dead in the eye. The Bible describes him as a flaming fire, burning eyes, feet that look like brass that they'd walk through a furnace. My God, that's enough to scare you to death. You got to stand before him. And you might give every excuse you can why you didn't give your heart to God, but he's going to take it personal when he let his son Jesus come to the earth and die for your sins on that old rugged cross, and you lived your life, you flaunted your ways. My God, it's going to be horrible. The half's never been told. And if you're found, which you will be found guilty because the books are there and they'll be open, you'll be in denial. They'll be screaming and wailing, I think, there. But there'll be a garrison of angels, I believe. And the Bible says that the Lord, when their name's not found in that book, he said he cast them in to the lake of fire. See, we preach so much on hell. We forget, hey, it's not over when you go to hell. I mean, that's enough. My God, that's enough. But wait a minute, you're going to be brought up, stand before the great judge,
And then if which you are guilty, you'll be cast into the lake of fire. My God, how horrible that'll be. Why do I cry for the sinner? Why do I preach like this? I can just feel it. Multitudes are going to hell aimlessly, recklessly, without God, my God. You need God tonight. You need God tonight. And all woe be unto you that you sit and come to a local church, revival after revival, service after service. And the first times you begin to come, you quenched. You had emotions about it. There was some fear that preacher distilled, that preaching put in you. But all now that you've just went on and you're doing your thing, do you still feel any convictions? Do you still feel any remorse whatsoever? My God, I preached the other night about the sickness of a hardened heart, friend. Your heart gets harder every time you hear this gospel. It'll go against you or it'll work for you. It can, my God, you can harden yourself to this like water running off a duck's back. And it's easy for you to refuse preaching like this. But one day you'll be brought up before the judge. And one day he might mention this white-headed old boy. He might tell you, do you remember Green River? Maybe this is the last thing we'll ever have. I don't know. But do you remember how the people had revival there and they came out? They kept the lights on. The pastor kept coming. The evangelists kept coming. They kept preaching to you, but you sat through it and gave it no recognition whatsoever. I'm telling you, friend, it's going to be awful. A half has never been told. I want to talk about one more thing the half has never been told about. We're going to close. The half has never been told how wonderful heaven's going to be. Aren't you glad, church, you're going there? The half has never been told how horrible hell will be. But I like to just talk a little bit, and I'm incompetent about it. My words fail me. My wisdom fails me up here. I can't place it like I'd love to. But what about salvation? Behold, the half was never told. Can any of us witness to someone and tell them really how you really feel? How it was when you first experienced the great joy that come into your life when Jesus Christ, Holy Spirit, come into your life. Oh, when I walked out of that little church, my God, the moon looked better. Everybody looked better. I went home and I told my wife, guess where I've been? My mother-in-law was there. My wife said, you've probably been out one of the old gambling houses. But my mother-in-law looked at me. My God, I said, no, I went to church and God saved me tonight. Wow, hallelujah. My mother-in-law even looked better that night. I took my wife and babies in private. I said, wife, tonight I give you a brand new man. That's what God does for you. I don't know about conversion today. Someone comes to your altar. They weep and cry for 30 minutes to an hour. And then they say they got saved. And you don't see them no more. My God, that ain't God. That's this modern day deception. If God really gets in you, the love of God gets in you, you'll love the things of God. You'll love the house of God. You'll love being with us more than you do that crowd out there. Away with this new day preaching. I looked at my babies. I had to raise two daughters. Many a time I've had them to scrape up their milk money or go to their piggy bank and give me money. Go play it in them old card games and lose money. What a filthy sinner I was. But you know what? I looked at those babies. I said, Daddy's not going to rob your piggy bank anymore. I give you a brand new daddy. That's what repentance is about. It's not praying at an altar and feeling better about yourself and then going back to your own ways, friend. It's making a change. The old man is passed away, and behold, all things become new. Glory to God. Give the Lord a shout tonight. Magnify him tonight.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Lord, I run my sister-in-law down in town with my car. Wanted to tell her what God done. Man, that newfound joy. I wanted to tell everybody. My mother got so tired of me. She said, Glenn, you little mean devil, you. God knows you needed to get saved. But just get saved. You don't see me acting like that. You don't see other people acting like that. Just be quiet about it. I said, Mama, I can't be quiet. There's so much joy wrapped up in my bones. There's so much of God. I got to tell somebody. What's wrong with us today? We're not telling enough. The great joy that surpasses all understanding. Sister Desi, I don't understand how, you know, you're sick on your, I've been sick before, you have too. You're laying in your sick bed, your body's racked with pain, but inside of you something's going on that nobody can see, but you can feel it. The great joy of Almighty God's there. Someone can look at you and say, this might take you out. You might die with this. And you could say with that joy of God, oh, my God, honey, don't worry about me. Hallelujah. When I depart here, it's just my checking out place. It's just my flight ticket on to a new land and a new place. Hallelujah. Joy unspeakable. I'm inadequate. I can't tell you how that joy does me. I can't tell you how wonderful it is. That's why you've got, this is called believing God. Believing what He can do. And at the best that I can do, preaching to you, try to convince you that behold, the half has never been told. Amen? The Bible says you'll have peace. You ever notice Jesus when His disciples were fearful or afraid or He come up against a situation, remember what He would first say? Peace be unto you. Peace I give you. Man, thank God for peace. I went through a spell of anxiety and depression. I thought I was literally losing my mind at one time. I appreciate the peace of God. I appreciate a straight mind. I appreciate, my God, what God's done in my life. But to have that peace of God. I don't need no drugs. I don't need no alcohol. I don't need to find a party. I don't need to find any outer circumstance to please me. Here's the difference between you and I, sinner. We, the church, live on what's inside of us. You live according to what's outside of you. You run like the world. You talk like the world. You do like the world because you are of the world. You have a sinful nature, but our nature's been changed. Our new man's been changed. Oh, but I've seen you Christians make mistakes and sin. There is some of that among us, sad to say. And there's hypocrites among you, and I'm not going to that church. I'd rather go to church with the hypocrites than go to hell with them. Are you hearing me tonight? But words are just inadequate tonight. But I want to tell you, if you make it to heaven, I can say that, you might stand there in awe, looking around, speechless. Brother Wilson preached about it. Brother Nader preached about it. I heard great theologians preach about it, but the half was never told me. And I'm going to live up here the rest of my life. It was worth the few trials and tribulations I went through just to get here. Oh, my God, think about it. But all bless your heart. If you go to hell, come on, our singers. If you should go to hell, my God, it grieves me to talk about that place, don't you? I don't want a dog to go there. I don't want a dog to go there. Man, they could cry out to us. Think what it'd be like if God would let one come up tonight and preach to us. The half has never been told, the pain, the agony, and salvation. Sinner, all I got to tell you just got to watch us. I'm still enjoying it. How about you, church? Amen. You might say, why are you people coming out every night like that? It's hard to explain it. It's hard to explain what we've got in us. Hard to explain it. But I can tell you this, it's the best thing I ever had in my life. I wouldn't turn back that old sewer world for nothing in the world. I wouldn't go back there. You want to stand to your feet tonight for altar call? Oh, my God, thank you, Jesus. You're precious. You're precious. Would you give me a moment? All heads are bowed, please. This might be a little old-fashioned for you, but it's worked a many a time. Maybe you're a sinner or backslider here tonight. Might just be one of you, but you're worth it. You're worth it, honey. And you'd say, Brother Wilson, you know, I am fooling my life away. I am wasting my life. What if my buddy that didn't know the Lord, as far as I know, he did not make a confession of knowing God. One minute you're riding your tractor down the road, putting it in gear, you think, and open up a gate and it runs over you. And the next thing you see is hellfire if you're lost. This is reality. The half has not been told. If you don't know Jesus Christ tonight, listen. Would you just be slipping your hand up? The saints of God are praying. Brother Wilson, I don't know God as my Lord and my Savior. Just slip your hand up, would you? Slip your hand up right now. You might be embarrassed now, but if death was nipping at your heels right now, you'd run to God. If a tragedy took place right now, you'd run to God. Why? Because he's your only escape route. Hallelujah. Is there a backslider here tonight? You've backslid from God. You're going the ways of the world. You'd like to turn around and come back to Jesus tonight. I'm going to tell you, he loves you. He's giving you another invitation. This altar, we're going to open it. We pray you'll come. I've done all I can do. I can do no more for you. God bless you. I love you. Sing for us.
Said I have what you need, but you keep on searching.
Anybody?
I've done all the work.
Anybody?
But you keep on working.
Anybody need
you? You're running on empty, and you can't find the remedy.
Everybody all right?
Come to the well.
Everybody's got your ticket punch. You're ready. Is that right?
You can spend your whole life chasing what's missing.
They're coming. Why don't you come?
But that empty inside, it ain't gonna listen.
Oh, why don't you come?
When nothing
you know
can
someone
satisfy.
Beside of you, they're not saved.
When the world leaves you high,
and a bit of encouragement would help them come. Will you bring them to an altar? Could you bring them with you tonight?
All who thirst will thirst no more. All who search will find what their souls long for. The world will try, but it can never feel, leave it all behind. Come to the well.
Don't let the devil cheat you out of it tonight. They might not be here tomorrow night. They might not be here tomorrow. Are you ready to take that chance? Are you willing to take that chance? Come on up here and pray. Come on up here and pray tonight. Jesus loves you tonight. He paid a huge price for you.
Jesus, I surrender all to Him. I freely give. I will ever love and trust Him in His presence daily.
Praise the Lord. Before service started, sitting right up there, I felt gentle breeze of the Spirit of the Lord moving in this house. Or every song was sung or nothing. I felt that gentle breeze of the Spirit flowing through this house. I'm approaching the finish line. I don't have near as many days in front of me, behind me. I'm ready for the Lord when He comes. Brother, I'm glad of that night at a little homeless church by the side of the road, not knowing how to talk to God, not knowing much of anything about God. God touched my heart. God touched my heart. Really didn't realize what God had done. Preacher said, "You think the Lord's saving?" My answer was, "I hope so." But it didn't take long till I realized God had made a change in me. God had made a change in me. He's moved in this house, in this revival. Brother Glenn said this might be the last. My wife has said a couple of times, this might be the last revival we get to have before Jesus comes. Are you ready? Are you sure that everything's right between you and God? Brother said the books are going with him. He said a book and another book. A book and another book. 66 books in the Bible. Then when that book of life is opened up, he used to sing a song, "Search the book again." Search the book again. I thought my name was there. It'll be too late. It'll be too late. Not long after I got saved back in 1968 at a Holy Ghost revival. Not long after that, there's another Holy Ghost revival, preacher. Spirit of God falling. We was in church at 11, 12 o'clock at night. People were laid out all over the floor. Healing take place. Just like they said, Sister Pam back there in that room. They carried a boy of 14 years old into the house of God on a cot in a room just back off the platform. His feet was all busted up. The doctor couldn't even put the cast on his feet. His mother brought him to church and there was elastic bandages around his feet. Church prayed. Young people that was on fire with God got back in that room with him and the Holy Ghost fell in that room. That young boy come up off of that cot walking across the platform, Brother Glenn. As he walked across the platform, the bandage was unrolling. They were unwrapping themselves. Mother took him to back to the doctor and she said, put his shoes on him and send him back to school. God healed him right on the spot. I've seen it done. I've seen it done. I've seen a man, they brought him up the aisle, elderly man, never been married. He had a stroke right in the house of God. They brought him and laid him up against the altar. He sat there. Church prayed. His mouth was twisted around over on the side of his face. Church prayed. Kept on praying. They wouldn't turn loose. They wouldn't let it go. They kept ringing the doorbells of heaven. His mouth come back to center and come back over on the other side of his face. They just kept on praying. It was like Daniel. They just kept on praying. God healed him right there on the spot. He didn't have to go nowhere. He was at the hospital right there. God took care of him. I'm telling you, God's the same God. He hasn't changed. He hasn't lost none of his power. He's still able to save the worst sinner. Paul said he was the chief of the sinners. Become one of the greatest men you ever read about. That's God. I don't want to take up the time, but it was sure before it even started. I just felt that gentle breeze sweeping through. I told the sister, I said, the Spirit of the Lord already moving in this house. Already moving in this house.
Can you worship him tonight just a little bit? Lord, we thank you. Go ahead, Brother Jason, sing.
Every time I try to make it on my own, every time I try to stand, I start to fall. And all those lonely roads that I have traveled on, there was Jesus. When the life I built came crashing to the ground, when the friends I had were nowhere to be found, I couldn't see it then, but I can see it now. There was Jesus. In the waiting, in the search, in the healing, hurting, like a blessing buried in the broken pieces. Every minute, every moment, where I've been and where I'm going, even when I didn't know it or couldn't see it, there was Jesus. For this man who needs amazing kind of grace, a forgiveness at a price I couldn't pay. I'm far from perfect, so I thank God every day. There was Jesus. There was Jesus. In the waiting, in the search, in the healing, hurting, like a blessing buried in the broken pieces. Every minute, every moment, I've been and where I'm going, even when I didn't know where or couldn't see it, there was Jesus. Try to make it on my own. Every time I try to stand, I start to fall. And all those lonely roads that I have traveled on, there was Jesus. When the life I built came crashing to the ground, when the friends I had were nowhere to be found, I couldn't see it then, but I can't see it now. There was Jesus.
In the shadows of the alleys,
there was Jesus.
He's been in the fire, he's been in the flood, always is and always was. Oh, I'll never walk alone. On the mountains, in the valleys,
there was Jesus.
In the shadows of the alleys, fire has been in the flood, always is and always was. No, I'll never walk alone. You were always there. You were always gone. My heart is full of sorrow. I can't believe how much I've let you down. But I dread the pain that waits for me tomorrow. When the sun reveals my broken dreams scattered on the ground, please forgive me. I need your grace to make it through. All I have is you, and I'm at your mercy. Lord, I serve you until my dying day. I'll help others find the way at your mercy. Please forgive me. You see, I can't believe the God of earth glory would take the time to care for a sinner like me. But I read in the Bible that old story, how Jesus pled for my forgiveness while he was dying on the tree. Please forgive me. Your grace to make it through. All I have is you at your mercy. Lord, I serve you till my dying day. I'll help others find the way at your mercy. Please forgive me.
the sight that saves a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. See, there's been through many dangers, through all my toils in my snares, I have already come. Disgrace had brought me safe this far, and it'll be grace that's gonna lead me home.
Shining as the sun, we know less days to sing God's praise than when we first begun. Praise God, 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 praise God. Praise God, praise God. How beautiful heaven must be. Sweet home of the happy and free. Fair haven of rest for the weary. How beautiful heaven must be. We read of a place that's called heaven. Made for the pure and the free. These truths in God's word He has given. How beautiful heaven must be. Must be. Sweet home of the happy and free.
the weak,
for the weak.
How beautiful heaven must be. The angels so sweetly are singing up there by the beautiful sea. Sweet chords from their golden hearts are ringing. No drooping, no pining, and all who will come be free.
Sing it out with me tonight.
Oh, how you
must be.
Oh, must be.
A host of a happy heaven.
How many's happy in the Lord tonight? Can you give him glory?
Jesus, for the cleansing power, are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? Are your garments spotless? Are they white as snow? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? Are you washed in the blood?
in the soul, cleansing blood of the Lamb. Are your garments spotless? Are they white as snow? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb?
The Savior's side, are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? Or do you rest each moment in the crucified? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb?
Are you washed in the blood, in the soul cleansing blood of the Lamb? Are your garments spotless? Are they white? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb?
Bridegroom cometh, will your robes be white? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? Will your soul be ready for the mansion bright? And be washed in the blood of the Lamb?
Are you washed in the blood, in the soul? Blood of the Lamb. Are your garments spotless? Are they white as snow? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb?
We'll lay aside those garments that are stained with sin and be washed in the blood of the Lamb. Well, there's a fountain flowing for the son, oh, unclean, and washed in the blood of the Lamb.
Are you washed in the blood, in the soul cleansing blood of the Lamb? Are your garments spotless? Are they white as snow? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb?
Troubles vanish.
My troubles are
His mercy is new every morning if you'll just listen to this word.
Judge turned my way. It looks like you're guilty. Now what do you say? I spoke of your right. I have no covered my sins, forgiven when mercy walked in.
Shouting time in heaven, a sinner once lost is found. It's shouting time in heaven, salvation has been brought down.
See?
Well, it's shouting time in heaven, a sinner once lost is found. It's shouting time in heaven, salvation has been brought down. No wonder the angels rejoice to know my sins have been covered by the crimson flow. Now I'm feeling fine. I'm walking on the highway with my Lord. Names written down in the courts above. It's shouting time in heaven. Oh yes, it's shouting time. Oh, I will arise and go with Jesus. He will embrace me in his arms, in the arms of Christ my Savior. Oh, there are 10,000 charms. It's shouting time in heaven, a sinner once lost is found. It's shouting time in heaven, salvation has been. The crimson flow, now I'm feeling fine. Oh, I'm walking on the highway with my Lord. Names written down in the courts above. It's shouting time in heaven. Oh, yes, it's shouting time. And go with Jesus. He will embrace me in his arms, in the arms of Christ my Savior. Oh, there are 10,000 charms. It's shouting time in heaven, a sinner once lost is found. It's shouting time in heaven, salvation has been brought down. By the crimson flow, now I'm feeling fine. Oh, I'm walking on the highway with my Lord. Names written down in the courts above. It's shouting time in heaven. Oh, yes, it's shouting time. It's shouting time in heaven. Oh, yes, it's shouting time.
Amen. One more time, give the Lord the best praise that you've given him all night long. No, the Bible says there's more rejoicing in the presence of angels over the one sinner that comes to repentance than over the 99 righteous. And tonight, heaven is having a ball because we've had a couple come tonight, and we appreciate the Lord. Give him one more good hand clap. Raise your right hand if you will. The Lord bless thee and keep thee. The Lord make his face to shine upon thee and be gracious unto thee. The Lord lift up his countenance upon thee and give thee peace. And we pray tonight that whenever you wake up tomorrow, that it's the best day that you ever have. Let us take care of some prayer requests. We want you to continue to pray for Olivia Strong. Continue to pray for Renee Chambliss. Continue to pray for Preston Hatter. Sister Retha Atwood, continue to pray for Charles Snow and the family of Billy Hill. Continue to pray for Brother David Carman's lungs. Remember Donald Moore. Also for Sister Glenda Douglas is over there. You all right? All right, she's all right. Remember Sister Cherry Sims. She is home, Continue to pray for, remember the Carl Mason family. Continue to pray for Chuck Durham, Brother Joe Simpson. He's supposed to have some stents put in this week sometime. Laura Patterson, Burl King. Again, continue to pray for Sister Pam Hubble and Barbara Kuntz, Carolyn Vonlinger, and the John Carrier family. Their visitation is tonight. The funeral is tomorrow. Larry Carrier, continue to pray for Tony Tillett. And also continue to pray for Sister Kathy Napier. She's got the same thing that Sister Pam has, the SI joint. They're going to do a MRI and then possibly do the same procedure that Sister Pam has just had. Also continue to pray for Sister Lois Wilcher as she is doing the things necessary to have a liver transplant. Remember Sister Alma Wilcher, and continue to pray for Sister Cheryl Brown. And how many with an uplifted hand would say, Brother Rick, we have somebody or something that we need the Lord to move in? Now, we're going to receive the offering as well, so we're going to have prayer over these needs. We're going to have prayer over dismissal and the offering. And he was kind of short and sweet. He was so short, so sweet, he didn't say anything. So, Brother Tommy Brother Tommy Hogue, come on up here. Brother Tommy. Yes. All right. Remember, I'm sorry, go ahead. Great. Also continue to pray for Sister Lisa Martin's mom. I don't think I have her name down. I meant to put it down, but remember her. Mrs. McQuarrie, correct. Vivian? All right, remember her. Brother Tommy? Let me see if I can get this thing going here. There it is.
Well, I'm glad I got my name changed. Good to be in the house of the Lord. Look over at somebody, say, I love you, and there's nothing you can do about it. Amen. Terry Wilcher, I love you, buddy, and there's nothing you can do about it. Amen. Can somebody say amen for Terry? Amen. So good to be in the house of the Lord. Somebody said some time ago, I'm not emotional. Why not? I mean, we're going to a big heaven after a while. And you know how long I'm going to live? I'm going to live as long as God does. How many's going to live as long as God lives? And that is forever. Amen. And I'm looking forward to that. I told somebody a while back, I said, if I get to heaven and I don't have a new body, I'm going to be disappointed. Right? But I'm going to get a new body like it on to Jesus. Amen. It does not yet appear what we shall be, but when we shall see him, amen, we shall be as he is. And I'm looking forward to that. How many knows eyes have not seen, ears have not heard, neither has it entered the heart of man all the good things that he has in store for us, but he has revealed them unto us by his Spirit. I mean, glad you know enough about it that you want to go. Amen. Appreciate Brother Glenn. You know, Brother Glenn and I go way back when we used to do warm-ups at camp meetings. Lord, I wouldn't want to go through that anymore. That's when they got those up that they didn't want to hear. Am I telling it right? I mean, if they got us up to preach and everybody just walking around and doing their thing, but Glenn and I would have to preach in that place, and we appreciate. But I appreciate your pastor tonight. We go way back too. Amen. Way back up Greaser Ridge, there was a big hornet's nest hanging there, and I didn't know Brother Billy Brown wanted it, but Brother Rick pulled me up next to it. And I shot it with a shotgun. That didn't help us. We backed up and he pulled up again and we shot it with a shotgun. Well, that's a long story. We'll not get into all of that. How many knows you shoot at them, they'll come at you, right? Amen. So we go way back. I'm glad we come from the country, right? Amen. How many's glad that you are emotional? Amen. I was doing a camp meeting up in New York some years ago, and this preacher there, they raise a lot of cattle there. And he said, Brother Hoagie said, the cows were getting out. He couldn't figure out how they were getting out. But he told his wife, he said, honey, he said, when I'll go around the fields and I will, and I find that place that's broke. I mean, those electric fence. How many's ever had an electric fence? Said when that I find that place where that electric fence is, he said, I'll take my handkerchief out of my pocket and I'll wave it. She said, okay, honey. And he went around the fence and he finally found the place where it was broke. And he got one in one hand, one in the other, and he pulled it over and stuck it together and he started waving. He was in a yellow jacket's nest. He was waving at the yellow jackets. She plugged him in and said he got emotional. How many knows if you'll get plugged in just right? And some of you have been plugged in, right? How many feels like you're plugged in? And so when you're plugged in, you're going to feel something from the other world, right? Amen. I mean, I'm not a stranger to this. I remember years back, you'd go to church, and maybe we got out about 2 o'clock in the morning. We had second shifters and first shifters and second shifters. And I remember going to Geneva when we'd have the first shifter. Then when Green River closed their service down, a lot of them would go down there, and we would stay till about 2 o'clock in the morning or so. And people prayed. We used to pray 2 and 3 hours, smack in the head, over on the head, in the mouth, under your chin. That was the worst, under the chin business. But I'm going to tell you something. We prayed till God done something for us. And how many knows it's going to take it tonight? Amen. What do you want me to do, brother? Here. Okay. He wants me to pray. He didn't ask me to preach, and so I'm sorry about that part. Amen. Let's just stand. Let's pray over these needs. How many knows where there's 2 or 3 touching any one thing? It shall. I said it shall. I said it shall. I said it shall. Not maybe, but shall be done. How many believes God's going to do it right now? Father, in the name of Jesus, we come to you right now. And Lord, we're asking you, Lord, to move upon all of these needs and names and those names that were shown on the screen tonight. Father, we pray that you would touch their bodies. You would move upon them. Lord, as you told us that if we abide in you and your word abide in us, we can ask what we will and it shall be done. And Father, right now, God, by the authority of what your word says, we believe right now that by your stripes, that we're healed tonight. And God, touch these that we're praying about. God, that you would move right now and let one stripe, one blood that flowed from his body touch those needs. Touch this revival meeting. Touch Brother Rick. Touch Brother Wilson, Lord, we pray. And Lord, let the Holy Ghost of heaven be in us, Lord, we pray. And Father, we'll give you the praise for it in Jesus' name. Amen.
Remember church. Yeah, buddy. Remember church tomorrow night at 7 o'clock, but prayer at 6:30 over here in the side room. Hope to see you back here again tomorrow night. Everybody say hallelujah and praise the Lord.